When Americans go to the polls to vote for the president, they're not actually voting for the president. Instead, their votes are tallied up and go to delegates called electors who supposedly cast votes on behalf of the American people. Each state is given a set amount of electoral votes based on the number of each state's representatives, plus two for the senators who represent them in Congress. Montana has 3, Florida has 29, California has 55. And in all but 2 states, Nebraska and Maine, the candidate who gets the most votes in each state gets all of the electors. So if a candidate wins the popular vote in a state like, say, Georgia, by only a few thousand votes, they'll get all of Georgia's 16 electoral votes. Now, of the entire electoral college, you only need 270 electoral votes to win. This means that candidates can win the popular vote but lose the electoral college and therefore the election. It's already happened 5 times. For a democracy, this sounds kind of undemocratic, right? Yes, and make no mistake, it was intended to be anti-democratic. Even its defenders accept that. The founders were mostly merchants, bankers, slave traders, and wealthy planters. Their goal was to preserve elite rule and prevent mass democratic movements, such as the abolition of slavery, from taking hold. Throughout the history of the US, it's mostly worked. For decades, the Electoral College helped guarantee the dominance of slaveholding elites, then afterwards, of Jim Crow-era planters in the South and wealthy industrialists in the North. And in the last 20 years, it has allowed candidates who have lost the popular vote to claim the presidency twice. It's consistently served to entrench the rule of a minority. In some ways, our country is even less democratic than many of its designers envisioned. Even James Madison, the chief framer of the Constitution, wanted a constitutional amendment to ban the winner-take-all rules that decide the Electoral College today. So while the Electoral College's defenders claim that it protects against a hypothetical tyranny of the majority, the fact is that it enshrines something much worse. A tyranny of the minority. This happens in 2 big ways. First, because of how electoral votes are apportioned, a voter in a small state like Wyoming or Vermont is weighted heavier than one in California or Texas. Your vote just means more there. Second, because of how polarized presidential elections typically are, the vast majority of voters, as much as 75% of them, have basically no voice in the presidential race. If you're a Republican in a Democratic state like New York, or a Democrat in a Republican state like Mississippi, your vote can feel practically worthless. In fact, unless you live in one of the 5 or 6 states that tend to decide every general election, you get no attention at all in a presidential campaign that's allegedly supposed to be about who should represent you. The Electoral College incentivizes most people not to vote. Why should they when they live in a state that doesn't decide anything? The system means that you can safely ignore the vast majority of the population to focus on a few heavily courted voters. And that skews how politicians campaign, as well as how they govern. Tens of millions of Americans live in cities facing severe economic and social problems. But national politicians never talk about urban policy, and they rarely talk about the deep poverty in places like Arkansas or West Virginia. Instead of the very serious problems facing our country, which affect both swing states and safe states, presidential elections tend to focus on boutique issues that might sway a few thousand people in key areas. And there's simply no evidence that the Electoral College helps us. Countries like Finland or Portugal elect their heads of state directly and are more vibrant and participatory democracies as a result. And the Electoral College is just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to how undemocratic our system is. In 2018, Democrats led Republicans in Senate races by 12 million votes, yet they still managed to lose the chamber. From a grossly unrepresentative Senate to widespread voter disenfranchisement to the unshakable grip of elite donor money over every branch of our government, our entire system is designed to serve the people in power. It is designed to breed apathy among the working class while cementing the rule of a few people at the very top. And the origin of that is the Constitution. There's no reason to treat a document written 200 years ago as sacred. The Constitution intended to secure elite rule and prevent democratic movements from forming. Because of it, every 4 years we have to worry about undemocratic elections in a country ostensibly founded on liberty and equality. There are simply better ways to run a government. I'm Bhaskar Sankara, editor of Jackman Magazine for the Revel Institute. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider becoming a patron of the Institute or making a one-time contribution.